In this video, I am going to explain biomechanical relationship of spines and pelvis. I want to focus on trunk rotation. If you think about trunk rotation, which part is moving a lot? Like when you do a golf, which part of spine is moving at most? Many people think about lumbar spines, but lumbar actually does not rotate at all. Actually, thoracic spines do most of rotational movement, and hip rotation is important. So when you want trunk rotation, your hip movement and thoracic spine movement is very important. Otherwise, if you focus on lumbar spine too much, maybe your lumbar spines get a lot of stress, then that can create low back pain. Thus, flexibility of thoracic spines and flexibility of hip joint is important for trunk rotation. So let's see his thoracic spine rotation. This is a little bit tight, and I wanna do trunk flexion like this or this. Trunk flexion. See, his thoracic spines move a lot. And let's focus on lumbar spines. It doesn't rotate at all. It's very slight rotational ability on lumbar. And when you stand up and do trunk rotation, hip movement is important. So I want to focus on here. This part is tight. This is costal vertebral joint. This joint connects rib and vertebra. When this place gets tight, that inhibits rotational movement. It's important for many rotational movements, athletic movement and daily activity. Good. Let's see. See, his rotation changes. His thoracic spine is different, then that creates a lot of rotation. That means lumbar is not included a lot for rotation. Lumbar is important for extension flexion, this kind of movement, and side bend, not a lot for rotation. See, it's much different, and this part is tight. This is multifidus. It's part of back muscle. Good. Rotation, much different, right? I worked on thoracic spines, rotation changes. That is why lumbar is not that important for rotational movement. You should focus on thoracic spines and hip joint. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.